In the beginning stages of a brand new relationship, it is easy to get swept in how amazing everything feels. After all, it's not called the honeymoon phase for nothing, that most times you ignore apparent warning signs. However, if your goal is long-term love, it is essential to view your new partner without rose-colored glasses and be aware of the red flags that can deter the relationship in the long run. In this video, I will share with you 9 early signs that a relationship may not last long. 1. You only feel lost. In the early phase, it is customary to get swept up in a deep whirlwind of passion and feel like you can't get enough of your new partner. But if your relationship is based solely on this intense passionate feeling and there is nothing else you have in common, that's a sign that things won't last when the sexy vibes fizzles out. According to Beverly B. Palmer, PhD, a clinical psychologist and relationship expert, the major indicator a relationship may not last is when there is only passionate love. If the emotional high from passion is the only thing holding you and your partner together, the relationship is at risk. If you fell head over heels in love, you can just as easily fall out of love. If sexually related matters are the only discussions that you and your partner share, your relationship is bound to end soon. A relationship built on lust will not last. 2. You feel like you can't be yourself. For a relationship to last long term, you must always be your genuine, authentic self around your partner. If you just started dating, it might take a bit for you to open up, mostly if your trust has been bashed before. It is okay to feel uptight at first. However, if you find yourself walking on eggshells and finding it challenging to reveal part of yourself, your relationship will be unsustainable. If you can't be your full self at the beginning of a relationship, it can be a sign that you feel like there is a part of you that isn't appropriate for the connection. It may seem proper to try and cover sensitive traits of yours, especially when you perceive that it may result in fracas in your relationship. Still, when you live out any authentic part of yourself, whether it be an angry part, depressed part, kinky part, then you are setting up the relationship to stay on the surface, which will not support long-term potential. 3. No proper communication. Every couple has different standards for how much or little they communicate with each other. Most times, these standards are set based on understanding. But then again, at the beginning of every relationship, it doesn't bother well for the future if you and your partner do not prioritize your communication. It is usually a problem if one partner communicates less frequently than the other would like. While almost everyone can easily say that they are busy, when you find that someone isn't responsive early on the relationship, it might be a sign that they don't prioritize you or your relationships in general. Erica Boisier, LMFT and founder of the Relationship Institute of San Francisco, in an interview with Bustle once said, "There are no hard rules on how responsive someone needs to be, and it's equally important to be patient. However, you ought not to be overly patient with someone because you might end up wasting your time." 4. You don't talk about the future together. One of the signs of a relationship that won't last anymore is if you have been dating for a while yet you haven't shared future ideas. For instance, when a couple has been together for like 3 months but have never talked about their dreams and plans for the next month, it could be a big red flag. A 3-month-old couple may not discuss getting married, but it's not out of place to talk about each other's dreams and ambitions and make plans towards achieving them. Couples who never indulge in futuristic and meaningful conversations are most likely to crash early. 5. No honesty or openness. Mature relationships allow partners to be forthcoming and open with each other because of their level of intimacy. Therefore, it becomes a big problem when you hide stuff from your partner or feel you cannot fully be yourself with him. Psychologist Antonio Borello told Huffington Post that hiding feelings usually happens when there is no trust in the relationship. Indeed, almost everyone has a part of their past that they never want to talk about. However, if that past event has any connection with your current relationship, then it is only proper for you to let it out to your partner. Even though some truths are brutal to spill, your partner should find out the truth from you than from outsiders. Being dishonest in a relationship shows that you do not trust your partner and the relationship doesn't have a solid, strong foundation. 6. You do not have a connection with your partner's friends. Let's take for example that there is no love between yourself and the friends of your partner and there happens to be a misunderstanding between you and your partner. Now, these are the same people whom your spouse sticks around on a daily basis. so it is almost impossible for them not to be aware of the misunderstanding. What role will the friends play? Will they help to settle disputes or will they create more rifts? Well, the truth is that they would not help to fix the misunderstanding. The best they would do is to stay neutral. Only a few will. There's a lot of truth in the saying, tell me who you are and I'll tell you who your friends are. While it's perfectly fine if you and your partner run in different social circles, it starts to become a problem when you don't flow with the people they choose to surround themselves with, or when they don't like those you hang around with. And this may be an early sign that the two of you are not well matched. 7. You don't accept each other's faults. The longer you're with someone, the better you'll get to know who they are indeed, which includes getting familiar with each other's flaws and quirks. If your new partner has an issue with some of your imperfections but expects you to accept them with no questions asked totally, that doesn't bode well for your romantic future together. According to Susan Golikic, certified relationship coach and co-founder of Unhabited Wellness, if the other person expects you to be forgiving and accepting their faults but they are not forgiving or accepting of yours, this is not reasonable. No one person on earth is perfect. We all have faults that need to be accepted. So if you are going to be there for someone irrespective of their flaws, it is only reasonable for them to be there for you as well. 8. They are stuck to an ex. Many people do not usually pay attention to this situation, but it is widespread and if not handled early, can break age-long relationships. If your new partner seems to still be stuck to an ex, even if all they do is talk badly about him or her or make comparisons between both of you, it's a major red flag that they aren't interested in or ready for a long-term future with you. Getting caught up in drama with the ex, stalking their ex on social media, daydreaming about them, trying to make you be like an ex, or even referring to an ex at every given instant, these are all terrible signs. Their attitude may be that their heart truly belongs to their ex. If this is the case, all it would take is one instance where the ex is extra nice to end the relationship. 9. There is no give and take. In the same way as giving value to your choices, how often do you compromise? Who is always the first to make up and apologize when you have a misunderstanding? The romance can quickly burn out if there's no give and take. If you've been sacrificing your needs just to compromise, then you'll be drained and exhausted soon enough. In every relationship, both parties ought to be at both the giving and receiving end. Else, the person who gives more will become too burdened and the relationship will quickly meet a loss because it is already a broken relationship. It might feel like you're overly pessimistic if you are actively looking out for red flags in a new relationship. Still, you are much better off if you notice something that has you questioning the future of your relationship early on. If you're one of our great fans who have been wanting to know who is behind this channel, now you can know. Kindly check the description box to join Steve Courage's personal channel, learn directly from him, or ask him any questions. Thanks.